subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss any video from my channel.
Yo, I'm now LCameraTV. Make sure you like, subscribe, and share with y'all cool things like Facebook and Reddit and Instagram and wherever else. And guys, I'm talking about my Panthers, man, and I'm pissed off, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying? I don't know why they reinstated Marty Hurney. I mean, you know, I was on the fence with him in the beginning, but, you know, I got three valid reasons why he shouldn't have been reinstated and we should just hire another GM. So let's get started. The first reason why is because Marty Hurney's already guilty in the public opinion. Meaning that the public, even though, you know what I'm saying, he got, I guess, cleared of whatever he did, he's still guilty in the public's eye. And that's bad PR for us, man. Especially with this Jerry Richardson thing going on, whatever. It's very bad PR. And yes, I know it's unfair that, you know, but he's seen as guilty even though he wasn't. But that's just how, you know, this world works nowadays. You know what I'm saying? Even if you're not guilty, as long as they say this about you, everybody's going to get it in your mind that that's what it is. You know what I'm saying? So he's really guilty of the public opinion, and that's not going to help our outlook as far as, you know, new fans and new people coming in, especially because we're raising our prices. You know, that also makes it, you know, makes people more trepidatious about becoming a Panthers fan. So to me personally, that's a big red flag, you know what I'm saying? The public opinion really thinks that he's a bad guy, whatever, this, that, and third, and by reinstating them, we're not really getting rid of that image that we're trying to get rid of, because we've been pretty good over the years of getting rid of that image. When Greg Hardy did craziness, we gave him the boot. You know, Jerry Richardson did his thing, he's gone. He's selling the team. And, like, the only person who's, you know, really left is Marty Hurney, and we reinstated him. So, for me, I want to reinstate him, you know. That's just one reason why I wouldn't reinstate him, but I want to reinstate him, you know what I'm saying, because, you know, we're trying to change our image, you know what I'm saying? Because our image has been getting worse and worse over the years over certain people that are on the team and certain people that did things and stuff like that. So for me, I would not have reinstated them on, you know, on that fact, you know, which is one, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I don't know. But, you know, I guess they can overlook that. And I understand, you know, everybody deserves a, you know, second chance and everything like that. But I'm just saying what I think the public thinking, and the public's thinking that he's still guilty even though he got, I guess, acquitted of all the charges or whatever, or the investigation the NFL did. The second reason is because we was iffy on him anyways, man. If it wasn't iffy on him, we would have made him the GM instead of the interim GM. You know what I'm saying? We was iffy about him. Didn't seem like we were going to give him the job in the first place. We just needed a bridge from Dave Gettleman to whoever else was going to hire. So if we were going through all that, whatever, he was the interim GM, whatever, and he was kind of like a bridge to a new GM, why hire him back? Just get a new GM. You know what I'm saying? And I understand that, you know, draft is coming up and the combine is coming up and everything like that, whatever. So they want to have a GM in the building. But the problem with that is this. If the new GM that they hired and Marty Hurney have two different mindsets or two different people they're targeting and two different scouting teams, now you messed everything up, because now you're putting him back in the situation, whatever, where the new GM has to come in, and then he might not like the players that Marty Hurney scouted. And Marty Hurney might view things differently, and it just messes up the whole situation. So if he's a half measure, which he is, you know what I'm saying, he's just a bridge between Dave Gettleman and whoever else we hire, just hire the new guy, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just don't get why, you know what I'm saying, you'll lead this guy in the interim role for so long. You know what I'm saying? I understand during the season. That's fine. You know what I'm saying? During the season, I get it. But, like, it's the off season. He had his old, you know, court or NFL investigation issues, whatever. That would have been a perfect time to transition to a new GM, because, you know, he was going through his old situation. And we all figured that he wasn't really going to be the GM, because being an interim is kind of like a half measure. You know what I'm saying? Now, I know he interviewed and everything like that, but I just feel like he was never really the, you know, the person they were going to hire. Unless I was wrong, you know what I'm saying? But I just feel like he was never really the person they were going to hire, because if they were going to hire him, they'll just hire him from jump. And plus, he put us in cat hell last time. So, I mean, I feel like if, you know what I'm saying, they're going to hire a new GM, just hire him immediately and put Marty Hurney out of his misery. Don't let this man, you know, be the interim GM all this time, whatever, to not actually get the GM job. That would suck for him. But I don't think he should get the GM job, you know what I'm saying? So, I don't know, that's just how I feel about that. And the final reason why I didn't want him to make Marty Hurney as the interim GM is because you already interviewed Lake Dawson twice, man. And then he's been part of, you know, the Bills organization, whatever. He knows Brandon Bean. He has, you know what I'm saying, like, he seems like the perfect candidate, whatever, to be a GM. And, you know what I'm saying, like, he'll be a new face. You know, it just seemed like it was going to happen. And now, you know, this whole Marty Hurney thing, he got reinstated. So I'm like, man, I don't know, man. Like, I would rather Lake Dawson be the GM, whatever. It seemed like they was going to make him the GM. And now, like, you know, Marty Hurney's back in the fold, you know, probably thinking about, you know, paying John Stewart $20 million or some crap because he doesn't know how to manage money, man. So, to me, like, man, I'd rather Lake Dawson be the GM. You know what I'm saying? It seemed like it was going to happen from Jump Street, but obviously, it got stalled out because of Marty Hurney thing. I still think, ultimately, he will be the GM because I think they have a good relationship with him and they gave him 2 interviews, whatever, unlike everybody else. But I just think they stole the move because of Marty Hurney, and I'm like, man, get this dude out of here, bro. He's, you know what I'm saying? He's already, you know, the public really don't rock with him now anymore because of the whole situation. You know what I'm saying? You guys didn't really care for him because if you really wanted him, you would just make him the GM instead of the interim GM. And Lake Dawson seemed like a good candidate, man. So, just, you know, I know it sucks. You know, I know you don't want to, you know, you have a good rapport with Marty Hurney and the Panthers like Marty Hurney and everything like that. But get this man the boot, man. I'm not going to lie. You got to give him the boot because for so many reasons, you know what I'm saying? And the reason I also just, you know, told you guys. So, hopefully they'll give him the boot. Lake Dawson will get the job, but we'll see what happens. Well, that's it for me, guys. Make sure you like, subscribe, and share this video. Cool things like Facebook and Reddit and Instagram and wherever else, man. And get in the comment section. How do you feel about Marty Hurney getting reinstated? Do you like it? Do you dislike it? Would you rather see Lake Dawson as a GM? Because that's definitely how I feel. You know, he got 2 interviews. He know Brandon Bean. He seemed like he, you know, will be pretty good in the organization, everything like that, whatever. But, you know, I think the Marty Hurney thing slowed him down. And I think they kind of feel bad, you know, because they don't want to just give him the boot like that. But, hey, man, you know what I'm saying? He wasn't that good the first time. I don't think he's going to be that good the second time. Get a new face in there. Get Lake Dawson in there. I think it'll be better for us. Let me know what you guys think about that, and I'll see y'all next time.